Hello friends, welcome back to Chennagiri's Nursing Education Tutorials. Whenever we want to do any work or task, what we will do? We do planning, isn't it? Yes, in research also, we must do the planning before taking or selecting a topic for research. Then, what all things we must include in our planning is a big question to each and everyone. That is why here I am giving you some tips regarding planning, that is, what all things we must include in planning. Those are, number 1, interested area and topic. Number 2, reviewing the related literatures. Number 3, checking the feasibility of the topic. Number 4, research approach and design. Number 5, assumptions and hypothesis. Number 6, samples and sampling criteria and methods. Number 7, materials and methods, etc. So friends, in previous lecture, we have already discussed about some of the topics whatever I have listed above. So in this session, let us discuss about research approach and designs. If you have not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe it now and do not forget to like the video, press the bell icon and share the videos to your friends. So friends, let us begin with today's session, that is research approach and design. Friends, we do have lot of confusion between research approach and design. These are just two lines of railway track. And we can't able to do the research without these two. The question arises here, what is the meaning of approach and design? Let us discuss regarding research approach first. The approaches of research are broadly classified into two. Those are qualitative and quantitative research approaches. Now, recently some investigators are using both approaches in a single study. That is qualitative plus quantitative, which had gained another category of research study, that is mixed method research study in recent past years. Let us see the meaning of research approach. Research approach involves the description of the plan to investigate the phenomena under study in a structured, that is quantitative, unstructured, that is qualitative, or a combination of the two methods, that is qualitative plus quantitative. In this, we can visualize two main terms, those are qualitative and quantitative. Then what is the meaning of qualitative and quantitative? Qualitative is expressive in nature, whereas quantitative is measurable in nature. For example, here we can take ice creams of two different brands, that is A and B. If the question was asked to you that which brand is good, then the answer may be A is better than B. So the quality can be expressed in terms of good, better, best, excellent, awesome, etc. If you ask how much quantity of ice cream that you ate today, then the answer may be 100 grams, 200 grams, 300 grams, etc. So, quantity can be measured easily in terms of kilograms, pounds, meters, liters in case of liquid, height, weight, etc. Yes friends, here we can conclude that there are two main approaches to research, namely quantitative approach and qualitative approach. The quantitative approach involves the collection of quantitative data, which are put to rigorous quantitative analysis in a formal and rigid manner. This approach further includes experimental, inferential, and simulation approaches to research. Meanwhile, the qualitative approach uses the method of subjective assessment of opinions, behavior, and attitudes. Research in such a situation is a function of the researchers' impressions and insights. The results generated by this type of research are either in non-quantitative form or in the form of which cannot be put to rigorous quantitative analysis. Usually, this approach uses techniques like in-depth interviews, focus group interviews, and projective techniques. I hope all of you have understood the meaning of approach. Let us go ahead with that. The factors that affect in selecting research approach. Those are number 1, population, sample and sampling technique. Number 2, the time, place and sources of data collection. Number 3, tools and methods of data collection. Number 4, methods of the data analysis. Friends, I will explain regarding these terms in next upcoming lecture videos. Here, you just remember the terms as it is. Yes, friends, this is about research approach, and next we will see about the research designs. Let us see the definition of research design. Many authors have defined design in their own way. So here I am quoting some of the best definitions. Those are number 1, the research design is the master plan specifying the methods and procedures for collecting and analyzing the needed information in a research study. Number 2, research design can be defined as a blueprint to conduct a research study, which involves the description of research approach, study setting, sampling size, sampling technique, tool and methods of data collection, and analysis to answer specific research question or for testing research hypothesis. Then third one is, research design is a plan of how and where data are to be collected and analyzed. The next one is, research design is the researcher's overall plan for answering the research questions or testing the research hypothesis. Yes, friends, when we see the majority of definitions, all definitions say that the research design means it is a blueprint of complete research, what the investigator wanted to do for seeking answers for research question or testing the hypothesis. Next, we will see the elements of research design. The elements of research design include, the first one is approach. It may be qualitative or quantitative or both, with or without conceptual framework. Second one is populations, sample and sampling technique. Third one is time and method of data collection. Fourth one is tools and methods. And fifth one is method of analysis. Friends, I will explain these elements of research design as they constitute single topic in research and methodology in next upcoming lecture video. So next we will move to factors that affect in selecting research designs. Those are number 1, nature of the research problem, means what kind of problem you are selecting for your study, either it may be qualitative, quantitative or both, or you want to do the survey of a question, etc. Next one is purpose of the study. What purpose you are going to do the study? And already we have discussed various purposes of research in previous lecture videos. Next one is researchers' knowledge and experience, means the selection of design is completely dependent on the experience of the researcher and on his knowledge. Next one is researcher interest and motivation. It is also dependent on the interest of the researchers. Next one is research ethics and principle. It also depends on the Research ethics and principles means feasibility of the study. And next one is subjects and participants. Subjects and participants means sample. This is very important in research, and without sample, research will not take place. Hence, before choosing a design, we must get the clarification about our samples. And next one is resources. Resources are also equally important as the sample, and without resources, we can't able to conduct the research. And next one is time. Research may consume much time, but investigator must schedule his study in given time. Next one is possible control on extraneous variables. Extraneous variables which affect the study results. So here, investigator must choose a design which controls the extraneous variables. Next one is users of the study findings. We must choose a design by keeping in mind of users of our study results, which must be feasible to them in using and applying research findings in their day-to-day activities. Okay friends, this is about the factors that affect in selecting the research designs. Next, we will move to types of research designs. Research designs are broadly classified into two types. Number one, quantitative research designs, and number two, qualitative research designs. Let us discuss on quantitative research designs. Quantitative designs are further classified into experimental research design, non-experimental research designs, and other additional designs. First, we'll go for experimental research design. A research design is said to be experimental, then it must satisfy the main three characteristics. Those are randomization, control, and manipulation. Randomization means while choosing the samples for the study, random selection method must be used, which eliminates the sample selection bias. Control means the design must control the extraneous variables, means the researcher must include experimental and control group in his research study. Manipulation means the study must include or have independent variable on which the research questions will be answered or hypothesis will be tested. Based on these three characteristics, experimental research designs are broadly classified into true experimental, quasi-experimental, and pre-experimental research designs. Dear friends, we will discuss in detail about these three designs in next upcoming videos. Till that time, take care, and thank you for watching and listening my lecture. Thank you.